Hello students, in continuation with our first video, in the first video we have seen what are the presenting parts to the lung like apex, base, the three borders, anterior border, posterior border, inferior border and the two surfaces, costal surface and the medial surface. And we have also seen the points of the site determination in my first video. In second video, we are going to see what are the various impressions present and what are the various relations present. As this is the blunt apex which is related anteriorly, it is having an impression for the lodgement of the subclavian artery. Lateral to it, there are the impressions for the presence of a ribs. So these depressions are the impressions of the ribs and these elevations, these are nothing but the for the intercostal spaces. Now in continuity with that, the medial surface is divided into two parts, the vertebral part which is smaller in nature and the large mediastinal part. So these mediastinal impressions, they are different for the right lung and different for the left lung. So we will see what are the various impressions present on the mediastinal surface of the right lung first. The right lung, as this is the right lung, it is having various cardiac impression. So this part is related, this shallow part is related with the right atrium. As we know, in the right atrium, superior and the inferior vena cava are opening. This is the inferior vena cava impression. You can see it here. This is the impression for the superior vena cava. So, right atrium is present in this area. This is the superior vena cava impression, which is formed by the joining of the right and left brachiocephalic vein. The arching of the root of the lung on the right side is by the azygos vein. So, you can see, this is the impression for the azygos vein which is draining into this superior vena cava. So posterior to the superior vena cava is the impression for the trachea and more posteriorly is the esophagus which is running downward. Along with that, few impressions, they are invisible or not clearly defined. These are the impressions for the nerves, right phrenic nerve and the right vagus nerve. So these are the impressions present on the right side of the lung. We will see the structures which are present at the root of the lung again. On the right side, we are having two bronchus, ip arterial bronchus and hype arterial bronchus. So, ip arterial bronchus is present above to this artery, pulmonary artery, and hype arterial is below to the pulmonary artery. So, the structures present at the root of the lung, this is the thick walled bronchus, then the pulmonary artery, and these two are the pulmonary vein, superior pulmonary vein and inferior pulmonary vein. So, arrangement of the structures from before backward, this is the anterior side and this will be the posterior side. So, the arrangement of the structure from before backward, these are vein, artery and bronchus, VAB, vein, artery and bronchus. And from above downward, the arrangement of the structures are ip arterial bronchus, pulmonary artery, hyperarterial bronchus and the inferior pulmonary vein. These are the structures present at the root of the lung, which is nothing but the short broad pedicle connecting the lung to the mediastinum. Along with these structures which are visible one, few are the structures like bronchial veins, bronchial artery, anterior and the posterior pulmonary plexuses of the nerves, lymphatics and the lymph nodes. They are also the contents of this root of the lung. Now we will see the left lung. These costal impressions are same on both sides. Here you can clearly define the ribs impression, which are the depressed part, and this elevation part are nothing but these are for the intercostal spaces. This is the impression for the subclavian artery present near to the apex. As you know, the anterior border, it is interrupted by the presence of the cardiac notch, and this is the tongue shaped projection called as the lingula. We will see what are the visceral impressions present on the mediastinal part of the medial surface. Now, this is the cardiac impression which is very much deep as compared to the left lung. So, this is the impression for the left ventricle, left auricle, then ascending aorta, arch of aorta. So, arching over of the root of the lung on the left side is by the arch of aorta and this will be the descending aorta. Medial to the arch of aorta will be the impression for the pulmonary trunk. Posterior, so this arch of aorta is having branches, left subclavian artery, which is this impression. So this is the impression for the left subclavian artery, posterior to which is the impression for the trachea, thoracic duct and the esophagus, same as like the right lung. So again, the right phrenic nerve and the right phrenic nerve and the right vagus nerve, they are also seen on this surface. Now Now we will see what are the structures present at the root of the left lung. As this is the left lung, we will see the structures present at the root of the left lung. This is the pulmonary artery. From above downward, there will be the presence is artery. This is the thick walled bronchus. You can see the thickness, and this is the vein, inferior pulmonary vein, and this will be the superior pulmonary vein. So arrangement of the structures from before backward, these are artery, bronchus, and the vein. And from above downward, these are the artery, bronchus, and the so inferior pulmonary vein. So here there will be the superior, from before backward, there will be the superior pulmonary vein, the pulmonary artery, the bronchus. Only one bronchus is present on the left side. And from above downward, these are the artery, bronchus, and the inferior pulmonary vein. This is the pulmonary ligament which provide the dead space for the enlargement of this pulmonary veins, inferior pulmonary vein. Now we will see the differences between the right lung and the left lung. As you all of you know, first and foremost point is that the structures present at the root of the lung is different. The right lung, it is longer, narrower one, whereas the left lung, it is short and broad one. Anterior border of the right lung, it is straight, it is not interrupted one, whereas the anterior border of the left lung, it is interrupted by the presence of the cardiac notch, because of which lingula is present. Here the lingula, it is absent one. Then the impression present at the root of the lung, here there are the presence of the two bronchus, epiarterial and the hyperarterial bronchus present at the root of the lung. On the left side only we are having one bronchus. Again, one feature is that the right lung, it is divided into three lobes by the presence of the horizontal oblique fissure and the horizontal fissure. But this is always not a fixed criteria. Sometimes the right lung may have two lobes and sometimes the left lung may have three lobes. So generally the right lung is having three lobes and the left lung, it is having two lobes. So these are the points for the identifications of the right lobe and the left lobe. The point of the site determination is that anterior thin border must be present in front, apex must be present superiorly, costal surface must be present laterally. So these are the points of the site determination as well as differences. Thank you.